Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Riverside Park Hotel and Enniscorthy Community College's production, our variety show. Right, so a couple of small things before we get started. Our fire exits are along the side here and at the back, and obviously in this direction over here as well. There are raffle tickets on sale as well, so some people got raffle tickets there at the before the show started. There will be more tickets on sale at the interval as well. We'll have about a 15-minute interval halfway through the show. A lot of work obviously has gone into tonight's show. A lot of people who have never been on stage before put in a huge amount of work and effort into it, so if you could just be mindful to check and see if your mobile phone is actually switched off, please, or on silent. So if you could just check that, please. Photography, obviously that's okay, it's grand, but just be mindful of flash photography, particularly in some of the quieter moments during the show and stuff like that as well. Okay, so I'm now going to hand you over to our MC for tonight, the fantastic Mr. Liam Sharkey. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Maher. Good evening, everybody, and you're all very welcome along to the Riverside Park Hotel for the TY Variety Show 2023. Right, now, just to let you know, this is going to be no normal variety show because there will be a few surprises for our audience members along the way as well. We'll tell you more about that very shortly because, as you can see, I can go wherever I want with this microphone. So be careful, there's nobody safe. Right, we're about to get the show underway and then I'm going to tell you a little bit more about a few other things after we see the first act because we have TY students on this side and on this side who cannot wait to get out here to give you a show. So, are we ready for the greatest show? Let's go, let's welcome the TY students of 2023.
Soaking through the floor. And buried in your bone, there's an ache that you can't ignore. It's taking your breath, stealing your mind. And all that was real is left behind. Don't fight it, it's coming for you, running at you. It's only this moment, don't care what comes after. Your fever dream, can't you see it getting closer? Just surrender, cause you feel the feeling taking over. It's fire, it's freedom, it's blood and open.
Come down, and the sun can't stop.
show, so we hope you had a great night. Okay, right, we have lots more to come, of course, but before we go any further, a couple of little things that we need to sort out up here first. Okay, so first of all, we have to say this, because we have a student in TY this year. Her name is Yara, she's from Spain, and she's staying with a host family here in Enniscorthy. She's part of our TY group, and we got word yesterday that her mum and dad flew in from Spain to be here tonight. So can we give them a big round of applause? They're sitting over around this area, somewhere around here. There they are. Very good. Stand up and let us see you. Stand up there. Stand up. Stand up there and let me see. There they are. Look, give them a big chair. And Mr. Wickham said we're going to pay for your flights back to the North. Okay. Also, as well, it's a very international feel to tonight's show, because also as well through our Erasmus programme in the school, where some of our PLCs went to Sweden a few weeks ago and did a 3-week course in Sweden. Tonight, the Swedish students and their teachers are back here with us tonight, and they're here tonight as well. So give them a big cheer. Just to let you know, we will be looking for a few votes in the Eurovision there in a few weeks' time. Okay, right. Okay, so we're going to be moving on to our next act very, very shortly. However, we're going to tell you what's going to happen. At three times throughout the night, you're going to get a chance to win a prize. Who'd like to win a prize? We're going to go section by section and see what happens. So let's hear a big cheer for this section here. That's very good. Over here. Not too bad. This section! I have to be careful, my mother is sitting in this section. Six! Let's hear it for this section! No. Very good. That was my mother over there shouting. Right, okay, so we're going to give away our first prize, and we're going to give it away pretty quickly. Who would like the first Easter egg of 2023? Now you got to shout a little louder. Right, we're having a look. Actually, this woman looks very excited to have an Easter egg. Hang on. Stand up there for a second. What's your name?
Margaret.
Margaret, where are you from?
Enniscorthy.
Oh, sorry, but okay. Right, okay. No, my joke, Margaret. Right, Margaret, stand up. You're not finished yet. To win the Easter egg, come out here to me for a second, Dave. Come out here. Right, now. Little did you know this was going to be happening, Margaret. Okay. Right, Margaret, here's what we're going to do. To win the Easter egg, the rest of you keep an eye on this. To win the Easter egg, you have to answer three little simple questions. We're going to play three television theme tunes. You've got to guess them. You can get a bit of help from the audience. If she gets them all wrong, there's an Easter egg for everybody. No, there's not. I'm only joking. We're not made of money. Right. Okay, so you ready, Margaret? Here comes TV team number one. What big TV show? It's in March. Simon Cowell is involved. Not American Idol. We'll give you one more shot. What is he in? Simon Cowell. What does he do? They're shouting it. Ant and Dec present it.
Britain's Got Talent.
Britain's Got Talent, yes. I'm not going to give you as much help as the next one. Here comes the next one. Here it comes. Now listen carefully. Say what you see. Say what you see.
Catchphrase,
yes. Very good. One more, Margaret, and the Easter egg is yours. You cannot buy these in the shops. Are you ready? Here it comes, the last one. Here it comes. What is it? It's as simple as that, only it gets a bit trickier. Okay, right, enough out of me now, because as if you didn't realise, I was stalling. Right, because we're getting ready for the next act. Are we ready to see the next act? Yeah! Right, okay, so here we go, hang on now. Right, so many pages. Right, here we go then with the next act, and this, we are going to a film set for this act, where we are going to see some very strange actors in a scene. So this scene is called The Director's Cut. So can we have a big cheer for the TY students? Here we go.
Thank you. doctor, he's over there.
Oh dear, let me have a look. I'm afraid your husband is dead. You'll have to call the undertaker. Goodbye.
Oh, whoa, is me? Undertaker, come slowly. My husband is dead. You'll have to take him away. Thank you.
Your husband?
Yes.
Are you sure this time?
Yes. He can't be dead.
1 foot 3 inches. Let's take this thing away.
Please,
you can do it next time.
You can't act.
I'm not being paid enough for this.
Look at you on the floor again. We've got to clean up. Ah, sure. Be all right too. Doctor, doctor, come quickly. My husband is sick and you will have to take him and, like, just check him out there. Thank you.
Hello, Mrs. Capita.
Hello, doctor. He's over there.
Look at him. Jesus.
Oh, what's wrong with him?
Bum, 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 bum. No bum.
What?
I'm afraid your husband is dead.
Yes!
You'll have to call the undertaker. Goodbye.
I'm going to be rich and I get all this money. Undertaker, undertaker, undertaker. Come quickly. My husband, he's dead. So I get all this money and I'm going to be rich now and you're going to have to take him away from me. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Your husband?
Yeah.
Are you sure this time?
Yeah.
100%.
I think he's dead now, would you?
Oh my god. Oh lads, it's only small, 13 feet, 17 inches. Oh. We got something on the market though. Let's go get it, let's get it out of here.
Gosh! This is an outrage! I quit!
It's about time to!
Yes!
Yes!
We're moving on to the next act, and just to let you know as well that raffle tickets will be on sale again at half time. We have some lovely prizes to give away down there. We have some dinners for two here at the Riverside Park Hotel. We also have some lovely sweets down there as well. There's loads of lovely prizes down there, so make sure you get your tickets at half time as well. Now, we're moving on to the next act, and this is called If I Were Not Upon the Stage. So what you're about to see is a lot of people who are in their own professions, but if they weren't here on the stage, what would they be? I'll let it explain itself. So once again, here come the TYs.
Straight.
my song. Directing traffic, directing traffic, one way only, please. 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 Directing traffic, one way only, please.
Under your chairs, there are two envelopes stuck underneath
two chairs in the room. If you have an envelope, you tear it off the bottom of the chair, and then I'm coming to get you. So maybe Matty will bring the lights up for this one. Right. So there we go. Right, so there we go. Now, have a look under your chair. Has anyone found an envelope? If you have, put it high in the air, like you just don't care. Right, have we found one? Yes, we have one over here. Very good. Are there any more? Fair. Good girl, May. No, that's a reserve sign. She has two of them. Good girl. Very good. Actually, we might have something for May in a few minutes. Is there another one around here somewhere? Have a look under your chair. Put your hand right under your chair. I think it could be in this section. We're coming back over here in a second. Right. Have we got one here? Has anyone got one? Are you sure? There's one under a seat somewhere. It could be on the seat beside you there, Breda. Look on the seat beside you there, will you? It's not. Are you sure? Right, we'll come back for that one. But there is one over here. Hello there. Right. Come over here to me. Come over here to me. Good girl. Give her a big round of applause. There we go. Now, what's your name?
Kella.
Sorry, what was that?
Kella.
Kella. Where are you from?
Enniscorthy.
Where do you go to school?
St. Aidan's.
Where are you going to school when you're finishing St. Aidan's? Be careful.
The tank.
Yes, that's right. The community college. You've won the East Normandy job. Right, open the envelope. Right, let's have a look and see. So there's something written in here, okay? Now you might need a little bit of help from the adults on this one. Did we find that other envelope over there, lads, yet? No, there is one over there somewhere. We'll have a look for it after the halftime break. Right, here we go. Now, so what does this say? Let's have a look. Now you're going to read that out. I'll hold the microphone to you. Ready? Read it out there.
What age is the person holding the microphone right now?
Now,
25.
This can go one of two ways.
25.
I'm going to give you a 5-year gap at either side. 25. To try and guess. Now, hang on, just get a good look there now. What do you think? Right, okay. What age to win the Easter egg do you think I am? 106. What? Hang on. She's having a look. Go on.
54.
54. 54. Who said that to you over there? Would you like to take another guess? 48. You're just inside the barrier. Give her a big round of applause. Hello. Very good, well done. Right, well done. Now, unfortunately, either that's fallen off the chair, but we'll have a look at half time. There's someone over here going to win an Easter egg in the second half. Is that okay? Right, okay. Have you found it? No, you haven't. All right, you just want the Easter egg. You're not getting an Easter egg just for that. Where that? Right, okay. Right, so, well done. Give her a big round of applause over there. Winning the Easter egg there. Just for the record, I am 27. Right, moving on. Right, what we're going to have is now we're going to have a little bit of music. Katie Cloak is one of our students in third year. She's a very good student as well. That's why we have her on the show. So she's here with us tonight and she's going to be singing with us. However, she has drafted in her brother from another school. But don't worry, we'll turn the tide there yet. Right, okay, but will you please welcome to the stage Katie Cloak, and you will be joining her in a couple of minutes, her brother Jack. Give him a big round of applause.
Thank you.
looking at me. Is this the place we used to love? Is this the place that I've been dreaming of? Oh, simple thing, where have you gone? I'm getting old and I need something to rely on. And if you have a minute, why don't we go? Talk about it somewhere only we know. And this could be the end of everything. So why don't we go somewhere only we know?
There's a very proud mummy and daddy sitting over here as well. So well done. Very good. They're a credit to you. Well done. Right. We're moving on to our next part. Now, this is a nice little piece. It's called The Master's Hand. And it's written around an auction room where there is a very special musical instrument up for grabs in this auction. And it takes on a life of its own. So we're just setting up here now. We're almost ready to go. And just to let you know, once again, we have a couple more acts now in the first half. And then we'll be taking a short break. And if you thought the first half was mad, wait till you see the second half. So make sure you stay in your seats. Right. Okay, so we're almost ready to go with The Master's Hand then. A nice little piece here. And as I said, it's based around an auction room where there's a very special violin up for grabs. So give them a big round of applause. Here we go.
His while to waste much time on the old violin, but he held it up with a smile. "What am I bidding, good folks?" he cried. "Who will start the bidding for me? $1, $1, then $2, only $2, $2, and who'll make it $3? But no, from the room far back, a gray-haired man came forward and picked up the bow. And wiping the dust from the old violin and tightening the loosened strings, he played a melody pure and sweet as a caroling angel sings. As he held it up with the bow. $1,000, and who'll make it $2? $2,000, and who'll make it $3? $3,000 once, $3,000 twice, going and gone, said he. The people cheered, but some of them cried, "We do not quite understand. What changed its worth?" Swift came the reply, "The touch of the master's hand." And many a man, with life out of tune, and scarred and battered with sin, is auctioned cheap to the thoughtless crowd, much like the old violin. A mess of pottage, a glass of wine, again, and he travels on. He is going once and going twice. He is going and almost gone. But the master comes, and the foolish crowd can never quite understand the worth of a soul and the change that is wrought by the touch of the master's hand.
Give him a big round of applause, the master's hand. Right, let's rise the mood a little bit again. We have a little bit of comedy now, and this is where we have a washing machine repair person making a phone call, and they're about to meet their match. So, we're setting up behind us here now, and we're almost ready to go, and then somebody else is going to win something else other than an Easter egg. There we go. It's dinner for two. With me. We'll see how that goes. Right, okay. So, we're ready to go then. Here we go. Here's baby in the corner. Here we go.
Machine repair Owen. Is your mother there?
Yeah.
May I speak to her?
No.
Why?
Because she's busy.
Okay. Is your father there?
Yeah.
Can I speak to him?
No.
Why?
Because he's busy.
Okay. Is there anyone else in the house I can talk to?
The guards.
Can I speak to the man in charge?
No.
Why?
Because he's busy.
Oh, Jesus. Okay, I need to speak to an adult, so is there anybody else in the house I can talk to?
Yeah.
Who?
The army.
Okay, can I speak to the sergeant?
No.
Why?
Because he's busy.
Oh, for God's sake. So you're telling me your mother's there and she's busy?
Yeah.
Your father's there and he's busy?
Yeah.
The guards are there and they're busy?
Yeah.
The army's there too and they're busy?
Yeah.
And what in God's name are they doing if they're all so busy?
They're looking for me!
Well done, give him a big round of applause, Peter and Abby. Well done. Right, Matthew will bring up the lights there if we can there again, because we've upgraded from an Easter egg to a box of milk tray. You don't get this easy. This time I'm going for a walk, because I'm about to read someone's mind. I have picked out someone as we're walking in the door, because you're thinking exactly what I'm thinking right now. So I'm going to go for a little walk. Hello, how are you? Hello. There's Kevin Lewis. You're thinking you want to give me a promotion, Kevin. Is that what you were saying? No. Sorry. No. Sorry, it's not him. We'll go back over here. Right, I'll keep away. Right, we'll go over here. Let's have a look. Hello, everybody. You all look very nervous, lads. What's wrong with you? Huh? What's your name?
Claire.
Claire. How are you, Claire? Are you well? What are you thinking about? I know what you're thinking about. I know. Right, well listen, would you like to try and win a box of milk tray, would you?
Sure, go on.
Good woman yourself. Give Claire a big round of applause. Claire, come up along here with me. Come over here. Now, for this to work, we need complete silence in the room.
Not a word. Oh, we do. Oh, we do, Claire. I know what you're thinking. Right. Now listen carefully. I'm going to read your mind. I'm going to ask you quick questions, really quickly. They're really simple. And you give me the answer as quickly as you can. Because what you're thinking about is written on this piece of paper that I've had since about 7:30 tonight. And I'm going to let you hold it, that I can't see it, okay? And that she can't see it, more important. Are you ready, Claire? So listen carefully. I'm going to ask you really quick questions. You answer them as quick as you can. Here we go. Dead quiet in the audience, please. I just have to tune into your... Yeah. Here we go. 3 plus 3.
6.
4 plus 2.
6.
5 plus 1.
6.
1 plus 5.
6.
2 plus 4.
6.
3 plus 3.
6.
Now say the number 6 over and again in your head. Keep saying it over and over for 15 seconds. That's it. Keep saying the number 6. Keep going. Keep going as quickly as you can. That's it. Over and over. And stop. Name a vegetable.
6.
Any other vegetable you're thinking about?
No.
You sure? You eat 6 for dinner, do you?
Yeah. 6 vegetables.
6 vegetables. Name one of them.
Carrot.
A carrot. Can I have the piece of paper back, please? Thanks very much. Would anybody else like a box of milk tray? No? Hang on. What does that say?
Carrot.
Carrot! She's done it! Well done! Very good! Well done, Claire! You've won your box of it. Well done. Give her a big round of applause. There we go. Very good. And Kevin, I'll talk to you after the show. Right. Okay. Right. We're ready to move on to our next act. We're going to set up behind us here now. This time we're swinging around to a teacher in the school. And this is Miss Anita Cullen. And she has dragged the other half along with her tonight. Her husband is here with her. Yeah, give him a big aw. No, I say give them a big awe. It's their first night out in 6 years. And they're here with us tonight. But we have Anita Cullen and her husband John, and they're going to sing a couple of songs for us, and one of them is an original composition. Right, so give them a big round of applause. Here we go.
to do is a song called Charcoal Hill that John wrote, so we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Well done, give John and Miss Cullen a big round of applause. There we go. Well done. Great stuff. Right, and they're starting their world tour tonight. They'll be hitting all the big venues. Right, okay, before we move on to the last act in the first half, and just to let you know, the second half is completely different because we have Jump Couture coming up, which is our little mini fashion show here. Yes. And also, as well, the teacher's lip sync battle. And who wins? You decide later on. Okay, so that's coming up. But to close out our first half, we have a world premiere coming up. Before all that though, where is Keely Weston? Keely, stand up for a second please, Keely. Because today is Keely's birthday. And we're gonna sing happy birthday to Keely. Are you ready? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Keely. Happy birthday to you. Hip hip! Happy birthday, Keely. Well done. And sure, look, there's an Easter egg hanging over me. There you go. Happy birthday. Give her a big round of applause. Very good. Well done. Right, as I said, to close out the first half, we have a very special production because what you're about to see is called Where There's a Will, There's a Wife. And this was written by our very own Katie Nolan from Transition Year. Give her a big round of applause. Now, Katie has also been published in the Irish Times and in the annual supplement Fighting Words. So she's a published author as well. And Katie has put a lot of work into this. She's created this drama comedy and you are really going to enjoy it. So joining Katie on stage, we also have Shakira Waters and Ben Murphy as well. They're all part of their tour. So, just a little bit about what the play is about. Here's what it says. Bridget Lynch is a sharp-witted and unrelenting farmer's wife. But most of all, Bridget Lynch is a schemer. Between keeping her husband, son, and the local priest in check, Bridget has enough on her plate. So would you like to see the world premiere of Where There's a Will, There's a Wife? Yeah. Of course you would. Give them a big round of applause. Here we go.
Did I ever marry that man, Peg? The life of the wife is awful hard.
I wouldn't know anything about that now. You were on cloud nine when he proposed.
I say I was on something, all right.
Butcher! There was none of that crack in my day.
There was, be God. He was even so bad at one stage, the priest was at it.
Do you remember young Father Healy? Hippie Healy?
Aye, he used to smoke some awful stuff. He used to claim to see Jesus and everything. I say it was his own reflection he saw. He had some amount of hair for a fella.
I remember him now. You know, I think I bought shoes off of him for my sister. The time of the jumble sales. I don't know what he laced them with, but she was tripping all day.
It's a pity there's no drug to get rid of old men. Why, I'd give for that man to go and leave me in peace. Anything to leave him as dead as a doorknob.
I can think of something. Go on, tell him you're pregnant.
You know, I'm serious now. What's tonight's reading on?
The value of health.
Aye, and your health is your wealth. We should practice our little prayer.
Our Lord above in heaven, God the poor and the sick, healer of ills and solver of qualms, grant me the senility to forget the people I never liked, the good fortune to run into the ones I knew, and the eyesight to tell the difference. Amen. The
No pity.
Sure, what we want it for? Don't be praying that it helped me win next week's snowball.
Then what will it be?
Tippex.
You hardly think that will work, Peg. You could be banned for life, or what's left of it.
When have you ever heard of anyone being banned from bingo? It's not the Olympics I'm planning on fixing. The prize is only £40.
You could be done for fraud.
I highly doubt it.
You needn't be so cocky. You think you're a Paul Newman in that sting.
That's not what that film's about, and you know it. That's one of them dirty ones.
I wouldn't know. I haven't seen it.
Well, how did you know what it was about, so?
I wasn't paying attention to any of that. I was too busy looking at Paul Newman. He's a fine man. Oh, yes, a fine man.
What I wouldn't give for Paul Newman.
And I'll drink to that.
And I thought you'd be a gable woman.
A gable woman? No, this house is two up, two down.
Oh, sweet Christ, no. No, Clark Gable, in Gone with the Wind.
All right, yeah, no.
And back in the day, you were mad from. Seamus Lynch stole your heart then, and your romance with Clark Gable was gone as fast as it came. What happened to that, eh? You were a great couple.
Ah, sure. You know it took us a while to have a child. I was 39 having Shamie. Too feckin' old. It was the shock of me life, of course. We were delighted, sure. We thought it would never happen. But then his mother came to stay when she was on her way out. And 3 years later, she was still causing me hardship. We were at it like hammer and tongs by that stage. That woman said vile things to me I dare wouldn't repeat in fear of summoning her wrath.
Mrs. Lynch was an old bag when she wanted to be. God rest her.
Aye, and that was it. He wouldn't let me tell her off or anything, and she living in my house.
When a man puts his mother above his wife, he shows how much of a child he was all along.
Aye. Where is that shop of mine? He's only gone down to the parochial house. He must be pushing the car, not driving it.
Ah, there's no rush on me. They wouldn't hold mass without us.
Aye, you've always had a soft spot for that boy.
Always is a bit strong. I wasn't so fond of him the time he broke my good teapot. Ainsley China, and he using it like a football.
That was nearly 20 years ago. You're hardly still holding a grudge over. He was only 5.
Never forget the face that wronged you.
But he's your godson.
So?
You are undaunted. Another drop?
Oh no, I wouldn't want to overindulge before Mass now. I never do before an appointment with the Lord.
Oh, that's okay then. Shouldn't be too much longer now anyways. Would you do me a favour while we wait, actually?
Depends what it is.
Hold on to the back of me while I check the wires in that telly. The sound's gone, but I say it's just a loose connection.
I'm hard set to stand straight. Never mind, hold you. Could we not just pull it out?
It's too heavy, come on, would you?
If anything happens to me, I'm blaming you.
Nothing will happen to you, I'm not that heavy or anything.
You sure?
I'll give you some slap. What are you at?
Stretching.
Stretching for what?
To hold you.
To hold me, she goes and shaking like I'm an elephant.
You are.
You're just an old bag. Come on.
Right.
Now you hold my leg.
Keep your knickers on. I've got you.
I have my knickers on. They haven't left since 20 years. Okay. Now, steady.
I am steady.
Okay.
I am steady.
Steady. Steady. Steady. Really.
Almighty Father!
God, your hip! Your hip!
God, oh my, are you okay? Well, I'm not as good as I was.
anyways. Go on, check it.
Oh, God.
Would I? This is your fault.
It's not my fault. Oh, do it again.
You go and get that. Stand up.
You're not doing a great job of it.
Well, I'm up now, it's too late.
The priest is at the door.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh! Father, tease yourself. I have to be going now. I think I left the immersion on at home. The price of electricity these days. I'll be seeing you.
Need it.
Hello, Father.
Come in.
You have tea. I've only made myself a cup.
Oh, no. I won't trouble you, dear.
Oh, no. It's no hassle at all, Father. Oh, you'll have a lovely little Vicky as well. Here you go.
Thanks, Bridget.
I hope this will be okay for you now. I reuse the tea bags out my own. Bloody things are gone expensive nowadays.
You reuse the tea bags?
Yes, Father. I did.
Inflation.
Yes.
Listen, young Shaney was down with me today. He's a good boy, you know. Though I fear there is something troubling him.
And that boy was troubled since the day he was born. Sure didn't my mother say it to me as she sat right there. There'll be no question of that boy, sire, if he has the scowl to match that husband of yours. That boy has the head of his father, as well as his temperament. 'Tis me own fault, sure, I gave his father's name after she said it. There's none of my people in him at all. They say babies are found under cabbages. Well, I say that's where he came from, all right. He's a real lynch, out and out.
Well, now, I've watched that boy of yours grow from a little curly-headed babe to a curly-headed man. And he may not be the clearest bell in the chapel, but he's a dead ringer for yourself. If not in appearance, then definitely in attitude. And he has blossomed into a fine young man under your tutelage.
I wouldn't say blossomed as such, Father.
Why, is he not a good son and a good servant of God?
I wouldn't say that about me either, Father.
Well, now, the boy tries his best, does he not?
If that's his best, I'd like to see his worst. The boy doesn't know the difference between the Beatles and the Apostles. He wanted to take Ringo as his confirmation name. He spent 2 weeks trying to convince me of Saint Ringo, who was martyred by that Chapman fella. The boy can't even lie with facts straight.
Is that not a testament to the boy's honesty and good upbringing?
I suppose it is. Cleared up with Master anyhow.
Did you?
Yes. I made him take John Paul before there ever was a pope. I'm a bit psychic like that. Now every second child's feckin' name John Paul.
Really? Even the girls?
Aye, Father. Even the girls. She don't remember Maureen Murphy had the baby. What was it? 18 months ago?
No, I don't think I do.
Well, like, bone and pin? Do you not remember?
I can't think I do, no.
Well, you will after this.
Oh yes, of course, I know her now, Mrs. Lynch, I know her now. And this is her second child we're speaking about, yes?
Second? No, she's on number 7 by now, Father.
We got 7?
Aye, 7. Like rabbits, Father.
Like rabbits?
Aye, rabbits. Shamey reckons they're trying to build up the Shamrock's hurling team to be our boys, but there's no hope in hell of that.
Well now, is that a hint of jealousy I detect? For you are blessed with but the one child.
I wouldn't say blessed now, Father. Then again, I wouldn't want to be your one any day.
Surely yourself and Seamus would have liked to have more children to share your love with.
Now, Father, I know you only call when himself isn't around. We should be queer if you weren't the priest. But I can tell you, there is no love in this marriage of mine.
Well, no, I'm sure...
No, Father, not at all. As my mother always says to me, a good marriage is built on hard work and fear.
The fear of losing each other.
No, Father, I work hard in the house and he works hard in the farm. He fears me and I fear what I'll do to him. Oh, he's a pain in a bloody hole. Lunchtime and a lazy beggar's late for his lunch. The bread's in the oven hot and everything for him. That Seamus Lynch is a very ungrateful man.
Jez, I may be gone, so.
What in the name of Jez wrong with you, Father?
I was supposed to marry Mrs. Murphy at 12 o'clock in St. Enns and it's 8:30 now. Goodbye.
Wait for me, I'll have a good funeral.
The writer of the piece and acting in there as well. So well done, Katie. Give her a big round of applause there as well. Right, we're going to bring up the house lights there for a second there, Maddie. Just before we let you go for a little break there, I just want to say as well that we have Kevin Hughes here. He's here from the Hope Centre here in Enniscorthy, and we are delighted to say that from tonight's show, from your generosity for being here tonight, we're going to be making your donation from all the profits here tonight to the Hope Centre here in Enniscorthy as well. So, Kevin, you're very welcome. And I better say this or I could be in trouble. Don't forget the Hope and Dream 10 run is on April 2nd on the promenade at 10 o'clock in the morning. So we'll see you all down there as well. Right, okay, you deserve a little break there. You've seen a lot. But when we come back, we have our junket chore. We have the teacher's lip sync battle and a big surprise to finish the show. So off you go, folks. A short break and we'll see you soon. Thank you. Right, okay, so thank you very much, folks. You're all very welcome back to the second half. And we're kicking it off with a bang because it's time for the teacher's lip sync battle. So over the past number of weeks, certain teachers on the staff in Enniscorthy Community College have been practicing things behind closed doors. None of the students have seen any of this yet. However, when you see it, you will not be able to unsee what you're about to see, if you know what I mean, right? Okay, so we're about to get underway with the lip sync battle. Remember, your cheers at the end will determine who wins. And the prize is 2 weeks off school, paid from the 31st of March to the middle of April, where you can take in Good Friday, Holy Thursday, and Easter Sunday. Right, okay, so are we ready for our first lip sync battler? Okay then, for one night only, live here in Enniscorthy, please welcome to the stage, John Bon Jovi!
So
cheering much louder than that for each act when we bring them back out on the stage. Right, are you ready to see act number two? At great expense to Enniscorthy Community College, the next group have reformed for tonight and for one night only because, have we any fans of the Spice Girls? Well, the Spice Girls are back in the house. Would you like to see them perform? Right, Enniscorthy Community College presents the Spice Girls.
Good evening again. So tonight, for one night only, we have a fellow rocker like myself, we're going to welcome on Mr. David Bowie. Oh yeah. Quite a strange bunch. So for tonight, for one night only, I give you the Oddballs.
Just to let you know, I am 57. I'm never doing that again. Right, I forgot about this bit. I was supposed to be back in the suit to do this bit. But I may stay looking like this for a minute. Right, Mommy, I hope you're proud of me. Right, we're going to bring back all the acts for the voting. Here they come. Right, let's bring them back on the stage. Here's John. Here come the Spice Girls! Just a couple of little things here. Due to legal advice, we can't win. But you can still cheer. Just not yet. Right, here we go. For the voting, let's see who the winners of Lip Sync Battle 2023 are. So, if you want to cheer for John Bon Jovi, cheer now! Not too bad. If you want to cheer for the Spice Girls, cheer now! I'm warning you. I give away Easter eggs. If you want to cheer for the Oddballs, cheer now! Thank you, but we can't win. So it's close. We're going to go to our independent adjudicator. Over here. John. Who would you think? Right. It's very close. I think it's close between two. I think between the Spice Girls and Pitbull. So, one more cheer. If you think it's the Spice Girls, cheer now. If you think it's Pitbull, cheer now. I think we have a winner. Who got up here tonight. Give them all a big round of applause. Well done. Lots of work there. And Pitbull, the check is in the bus. Well done. Give them a big cheer. Well done, guys. Very good. Off you go. Well done. Off you go. Well done. Well done. Right. We're nearly there. It's a school night. Right. Okay. So, here's what we're going to do. We are now going to present to you the junketure from the school. We have six dresses to show you before we move into the last part of the night. And what you're about to see, folks, is pretty spectacular. Okay, a lot of work has gone into this. However, I'm going to hand over to Miss Doyle, Miss Natalie Doyle, the art teacher, one of the art teachers in our school here, who is behind all of the junketure you're about to see. So she's going to introduce us while I change my trousers. Okay, there we go.
Hello, I'm very sorry. I didn't have a time to change, so you're stuck with John Bon Jovi. So I just want to say a few words about the class and the junketure first. So as Mr. Sharkey said, I'm Natalie Doyle. I'm one of the art teachers at Enniscorthy Community College and the one silly enough to undertake the first running of junketure that we've done in our school. With any other group of young people, this would have been a challenge, but with the enthusiasm and the work ethic of this year's TY group, this made the experience a breeze, with only the occasional shower. They took on a huge amount of work while showing respect, gaining new skills, and overall, to quote the class, bringing an absolute vibe to the art room. And in their own words, they slayed it. Incredibly proud of them, and for our first year we not only made it to the regionals but we also made it to the finals. But I don't think it would have mattered, because this group, you'll see the work that went into each and every one of them, they are phenomenal. And so well done. And you're also stuck with me to introduce the first one, and then you'll be back to Mr. Sharkey, who is much better at this than me. So we're going to play the video, and I'm going to talk you through the first one, and then the other videos will play, and we'll just talk you through the makings of the dresses, and we'll introduce the acts then. Thank you. So the first design we have is called Biodiversity. Our designers are Holly Murphy, who will be modelling the dress, Ruby Rellis, Shakira Waters, and Abby Lacey. It is a creation highlighting the struggles that face the LGBTQ+ community. The handprints are painted in the bi flag colours, showing the importance of allies' support. The white fabric is recycled out of plastic bags, fused together with heat and cut into petal shapes to create an ethereal light skirt. On the back of the fairy wings are examples of slurs that the bi community face on a daily basis. The skirt was created using a circle skirt pattern with old bed sheets and elastic, and the wings are constructed with wire. I'd now like to welcome Biodiversity onto the stage.
The materials used were tire tubes, seat belts, and headlights. A purpose-built loom was built by the students to weave the tire tubes for the skirt and cape. The corset was made from scratch using seat belts and boned with plastic bales of briquettes. Headlights were safely smashed and glued onto the boots to create a jewel-encrusted effect. This technique is echoed in the crown and the staff. So, the asymmetrical leather-esque design takes inspiration from the 2022 Alexander McQueen Fall Collection. Drawing from Celtic roots, the goddess Bridget is the muse of this design, ruling over not only fertility and motherhood, but also by passion and fire, showing us the versatility of the woman. Please welcome Hot Wired.
Thank you.
Right, number 3 of 6 is Victorian Couture. The designers here are Queen McRaven, the model as well, Holly Royale and Layla Breen. The world, as we know it, is filled with information thrown at us from many different sources. How accurate is this information we take in as newsworthy? So with the rise of fake news, this design focuses on the vast amounts of information from unreliable sources, using tabloid newspapers to highlight the sensationalism of topics that can be damaging to young, impressionable minds. Our aesthetic is based around Victorian steampunk era as a nod to the massive growth of the newspaper industry during the Industrial Revolution. So they rolled up the newspapers with watered down PVA glue for durability, then used a loom to weave the paper. They then plaited the newspaper to give a contrasting texture. The skirt was made with a basic circle skirt from elastic and a bed sheet with concertina folded paper attached. Please welcome Victorian Couture. Issues facing our oceans and the precious life within. Given the history of humanity, it is fitting that our design evolved from the deep blue sea. We took inspiration from the jellyfish and how plastic can mimic its movement through water. We used recycled laminating sheets and put them into sequins to form the skirt. The top was created using hairnets from a bakery. These were spray painted blue to represent the many depths of the ocean. The hat was created out of an umbrella and a bin lid. So, let's hear it for Ocean Paradise.
I'm
tonight is Motor Goal, and the designers here are Alan Krubis and Bartek Jerkovich. Now, here's the thing. Alan, poor Alan, fell sick on Sunday, and he can't be with us tonight. However, his co-creator and now model, Bartek Jerkovich, is here, and he's going to be modelling the dress for us. So, and by the way, can I just say, this man also was in an appointment in Dublin today and raced back and ran in that door at 10 to 7 this evening. So give him a big round of applause. There we go. So, right, so here is the outfit, and we're going to show you the video now as well. So seeing our PE hall net getting replaced inspired us to what could be done with waste in sport. We began collecting old soccer and footballs, and then these got taken apart. Each piece was spray painted. We created a pattern for a jacket and made it out of the base of the PE net. This same fabric made the base of our kilt and was layered with lots of the actual net. The mohawk is inside of a football. The hair on the mohawk was created by adding layers of glue to the ropes again off the PE net, and they took inspiration from the biker and rock aesthetic to finish our look. Let's hear it for Motor Goal. Side over here, they're going to go around the whole room and back up here so you can see the dresses in all of their glory. So will you please welcome back to the stage our jumper shirt. What? Oh, there's one more. Oh, I'm so sorry, Molly. I'm so sorry, we have you. Molly's mother is looking at me here saying, you better. I'm so sorry. Here we go, Molly. Right. Totally my fault. Right. Here we go. With 80s wannabe. Oh, mine only is written in front of me. Right. The designers are Molly Brady, who's also the model, Lucy Williams and Yara Binez. Right. So if you want to come out along there, Molly, and we'll talk about you there with the video. Right. So here we go. The burden of climate change has passed to our younger generation in a time when they should be just having fun. Starting in the 1980s, the natural variability of the Earth's climate started to transition as a result of human-produced greenhouse gas emissions, leading to warmer temperatures, increased melting in Antarctica, Greenland and other regions, and a steadily rising sea level. We used the 80s as a starting point for our design. The cut of the Rara skirt was first seen on the catwalks during this era. We used a loom to weave the fruit and veg nets to create the crop top. We use the very tip of the label to create the little pom-poms. These decorate the scrunchies, the seams of the top, and these form the flowers on the accessories. So, last but by no means least, it's 80s wannabe! you'll never guess what's going to happen now. What we're going to do is we're going to do the full walk around the room, which means you're going to get to see the dresses up close and personal. So now we'll bring all the dresses back on the stage. Here to come, give them a big round of applause. And here comes the music. So down the catwalk, off to the left, around the room. Off you go. It's sadder than that. But we still have the raffle. That's okay. But before that though, we are going to do the raffle now. Actually, we'll do the raffle now and then we're going to be inviting Mr. Luke Marr, who is the year head for TY, up onto the stage to say a few words. We'll be calling on Dr. Ian Wickham, who is our principal, of course. He'll be saying a few words as well. But before that, we'll get the raffle done, I think. So there's a raffle box around there somewhere. Miss Parker, maybe. Oh, we have it here. There we go. Yeah, very good. Right, so get your tickets out. There we go. Now, we have some lovely prizes to give away. And what we're going to do is, have we got the prizes up here? We have. Yeah, they're over here, are they? Right, very good. Right. What? We have hands as well, right? Okay, so here we go. Now, so what we have is, we have two Dinner for Two vouchers here in the Riverside Park Hotel. We have a voucher for Pettit Super Value. We also have a bottle of vodka for the parents. For the parents. We have, it's a Lily O'Brien egg. Sorry, I thought we were giving away Lily O'Brien. No, it's a Lily O'Brien egg. And also as well, a box of chocolates. Right, so here we go. We're going to fly through this now. So, will you put out one for me? Dig in there. Very good. Well done. There's the one. Right, let's have a look. Okay, it's kind of a salmon-y colour ticket. It could be pink either under the lights, it's hard to tell. But it's 371 to 375 on a kind of a salmon colour ticket. I'll give you the code number. It's AV3HFH54. So if that's you, are you down there? Yes, we have a winner down there, I think. We'll grab a voucher. There we go, very good. We'll have a look there. Right, we're on our way. Where are you? Put your hand up there again. Oh, there you are. Well done, very good. Do you know what? I trust you. There you go. Well done. Congratulations. Well done. Very good. Give her a big cheer. Right. Our next prize is another voucher for the Riverside Park Hotel for Dinner for Two. Eve, stick your hand in there. There we go. Deep now. There we go. Very good. Right. It's that same colour ticket. It's the next ticket. It's 376. Oh, actually, this could be pink. 376 to 380. AV3HFH64. Or 54. 54. Sorry. There we go. 54. Have we got that there? Oh, yes. Where are we? Oh, it's over here. Good man yourself. Very good. I think it's Miss Jessica Doyle's little boy. There we go. Very good. There we go. You're going for dinner. You're going for dinner with him. It's your husband. There we go. Congratulations. Well done. Give him a big cheer. Very good. Right. We'll give him a bit of a shuffle around there first. There we go. Right. Okay, girls. One of you hop up there.
I'm going for you.
Now, that's it. In you go. Right, the next one, here it comes. I think it's yellow, and it's 341 to 345 on a yellow ticket, and the code is different this time. It's AB157785. It's you again. Congratulations, well done. Right, there we go. You have won. What have we won? The... Oh, it's the bottle of vodka. Who's sitting beside you? Larry, oh, geez, he'll drink it all right, I know him. Hang on, we'll get you another one. Right, there we go. There we go, give him a big round of applause. Well done, very good. I'll tell you one thing. I'm not going back to Weight Watchers after this. Right, okay, here we go. Just in the area of fairness, dig in there. There we go, very good. Well done. Okay, it's a light blue ticket this time, and it's 401 to 405 on a light blue colour ticket, and it's AC 7P 6T 7K. 401 to 405 on a light blue ticket. Right, down the back. Of course it'd be down the back, wouldn't it? Hang on. Right, here's a voucher for Pettit. Thanks, Nicholas. Right, there we go. Right, Nicholas is on the way. Where are we now, lads? Next one. Lily O'Brien. Oh, look at this. This is a proper Easter egg. Look at this. Who wants this? Do you want it, Darcy? Do you? Right, okay. We'll have a look. Hang on now. We'll dig in here. There you go, girls. Dig in there. Pull out one. There we go. It's a light blue ticket again, and it's 186 to 190. And it's AC 7P 6T 7K. It's over here, is it? Well done. Oh, there we go. Well done, very good. A past student at the school. There we go. Well done, very good. And the last one. Is this the last one? Okay, the last one. Here we go. It's a, I'm going to pull this on myself. It's a pink ticket, and it's 146 to 150 AV 3H FH 54. 146 to 150. Have we got it? Where? Oh, over here. Oh, good girl yourself. The girl who thinks I'm 57. There you go. Well done. Good girl. Give her a big round of applause. Well done. Right. Right, Mr. Marr, come up and take me out of my misery, will you, please? Right, okay, so folks, please welcome the year head for TY for Enniscorthy Community College, Mr. Luke Marr. Here we go.
All right, thanks very much, Liam. You must be wore out. I hope you enjoyed the show. I had a sheet of paper here and I was supposed to write down a few people to thank on it, but to be honest with you, I was watching the show so much I didn't actually get time to write down anything on it. So I'm going to call on Mr. Wickham to say a few words to you, and then I'll come back to you again then afterwards. Alright? I might get something written down in the meantime.
Thank you, Mr. Marr. I do hope you all enjoyed the show tonight. It was thoroughly enjoyable, and it's great that we're back doing live shows again. It's a while. The Field was the last show that we did, and that was in the Presentation Centre 4 years ago. And as I say, I had no idea coming along here tonight what was going to be on offer, but I was overwhelmed by students, teachers, and it'd be hard to keep a straight face in the corridors tomorrow, to be honest with you. And a lot of hidden talents there tonight. Just a few words about the students. I know there's students outside of TY, but the TY group this year were exceptional. They embraced any opportunity that came their way. Junk Couture was one of those, but there was numerous things right throughout the year. And it's great to see them up on the stage tonight, and the confidence that they have is, you know, they've learned so much this year, and it really will assist them when they go on to senior cycle. They've matured as young individuals, but they're all very respectful and very good young people. So they should be applauded for their efforts tonight. The staff in the school, as principal of the school, I must say we are very lucky, the staff that we have in the school. They're an exceptional bunch, they're hardworking, and you know, they always put the students first. we care a lot for the students, and we always want them to, I suppose, fulfil their potential, whatever that is. But there's a great spirit in the school, and that's down to a real team effort in the school, and it's everyone rowing in, and you know, Tina and myself are very appreciative of the effort the staff make right throughout the year. So I'd like to thank staff tonight. I particularly want to thank a number of individuals who have been heavily involved in the TY show. Miss Jessica Doyle, Miss Anita Cullen, Miss Anna Nolan, Miss Natalie Doyle, and Miss Sinead O'Donovan. Now, there was loads of teachers that helped out on the night as well, tonight. I want to thank them as well. I want to thank Mr. Liam Sharkey. He's the one and only. Liam is a bundle of energy, as you guess, but his heart is in the right place, and he's a great asset to Enniscorthy Community College. So thank you very much, Liam. Mr. Luke Maher, who coordinated the show and did a lot of work in the background. Mr. Maher is not someone that likes to be out front and centre, but he will keep the show on the road. He kept me informed as things were going along, but as I say, I had no idea what was coming down the tracks, but definitely was overwhelmed by the show there tonight. I also want to thank Miss Tina Merriman. For this show to take place, there had to be a lot of supervision, a lot of classes covered, and in fairness to Tina, in the background, was covering maybe two and three classes during the week there, so thanks very much, Tina, for that. Didn't go unnoticed. Enniscorthy Community College is a school of Waterford and Wexford Education and Training Board, and tonight we're privileged to have two very important individuals here tonight, Mr. Kevin Lewis, Chief Executive, and Miss Emma Ryan, Director of Schools, and I want to thank both of them for coming along. I know they're very busy, but thanks very much for making the time to come along tonight. And finally, parents and the wider community, thanks very much for your support. It doesn't go unnoticed, and we're very appreciative of the support that you give us. And you know, the large crowd that's turned out here tonight, I hope you thoroughly enjoyed it. And I suppose the plan going forward is that shows like this will become an annual event. I know it'll take a lot of time, but I think the benefits really outweigh the amount of time that went into it. And I'd also like just to thank the Riverside Hotel here for hosting tonight as well. So all the best, and again, thank you very much.